How to change YouTube name in 2014. In this video, we're going to change the account name, the channel URL, the YouTube channel art, and the pixel photo for the channel. Okay, so we're going to start off at ground zero here in our Gmail account. And we'll look up here again on the right-hand corner, and we've got our YouTube account. And just popping in over there. And we're going to go and check out what we got so far. I set this up on a previous video. I've got this Going Somewhere Solo Gmail account for a Star Wars theme. But now I want to kind of dress up this account and also change my channel name so that it's more Star Wars themed. So right now I have it for Chuck G. And we're going to go and just go ahead and change that right now. So just follow along with me. I'm going to click through here. And this is, again, I've mentioned before, everything is tied with Google, so we're going to actually go to the Google Plus. It actually is what drives a lot of the YouTube here, so we're going to edit our YouTube name in Google Plus. I'm going to skip the tour right here and just keep going right through, and I want to change my name. You need to have two, if you set it up with two names, then you need to have two new names. So I'm going to go pick something here that's relative to Star Wars. So I wanted to pick All Things Star Wars. So I went All Things as the first name and then Star Wars as the second name. And lo and behold, when I saved this thing, it was available. It's amazing because there's just so much interest in Star Wars. So now I've got this cool All Things Star Wars name for both my Google Plus and my YouTube account. So if I go and pop back into my YouTube settings here, I will have that listed. Now I want to also change my URL for my YouTube as well. So we're going to do that. So we're going to go under Advanced over here, and you'll see here to create custom URL for my YouTube channel. And just out of the blue, I put this back in again. I put my All Things Star Wars in, and just, it's amazing that this was available because there are so many different variations that people just go and pick. And so there we are. So I've got a cool email. I've got a cool YouTube channel now that says All Things Star Wars. So I've just gone and renamed the channel here. The next thing I want to do is focus on the art of the channel. So right now I just picked a default art selection, and I want to go and make that more of a Star Wars scene. So I'm just going through right here. I had subscribed for some Star Wars stuff, and we're going to go and get ourselves some Star Wars art. So just hang on here. So you can also fill out, this cool leaked Star Wars episode that I found earlier in my subscription. And but right now, I want to go and focus on getting the Star Wars art. So there's a couple of different ways you can do this and not get sidetracked with all the cool Star Wars stuff that's on there and all the fan art that's been put on there. So here we've got the original trilogy where they've actually gone and edited the entire movie with all the prequels added in along with the original three movies. So this is cool stuff as well, and you can get sidetracked because it's all cool Star Wars stuff. So now we're going to go and change the artwork here. I've done a little research and searched for some art. The big thing that you're going to want to look for here is to get your settings right for the art, because not all sizes for this picture are going to work. You're going to have a certain size. So as we go through here, I'm going to show you how to get the right size. There's a lot of people that have already put up some cool art that you don't need to go back and reinvent the wheel. So if you look here, it's a 256 by 768, I'm sorry, 256 by 440 here, that will get you your Star Wars art. So I'm choosing this really cool image here. It's one from the opening of Return of the Jedi. And I was probably about 13 or 14 years old when that came out. So that was really cool. You can see here, as I choose the channel art, you'll see here how it's going to look on the desktop, how it's going to look on the TV, and also it's going to look on the mobile device. So as I select that, it's going to obviously be shrunk back, but there it is. That's a cool shot. It's got the cargo bay underneath there. And next thing I want to do is change the actual image, the small image there. It's a 256 or 250 by 250 pixel. And so I found a really cool Star Wars Starbucks little icon to put up there. So I'm just commenting right now on how cool that is to be able to put up on my channel. So again, the sky's the limit, whatever you want to do with your channel. But this is just a cool way to be able to personalize it, especially if you start really putting a lot of cool videos on your site. You'll have this instant thing is like, oh, that's the one with the stormtrooper in the Starbucks. So anyhow, there's just a myriad of things you can do. So as we're going through this video again now, I've renamed my site. I've renamed my channel. I've put some new art on my channel. So now I've basically got this empty palette now that I can just go and populate it with all cool things Star Wars. Word of a note here on the on your art here for your little icon, it can take a while for that to update. I just went and did the change in Google Plus, and I've had this happen before on other YouTube sites in terms of having that icon appear right away. Sometimes it doesn't. So anyhow, there's just all kinds of cool stuff you can subscribe to, especially that's all Star Wars. And when you start making your own fan,
okay, in conclusion,
Star Wars stuff,
I'm
you can go
very glad that you watched this video, and we will have more videos in the future.
So thanks for watching, and if you don't mind, please subscribe and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks.